Hello guys, in this video I will show you how to dual boot Windows 11 with Windows 10 with or without secure boot or TPM 2.0 support. You will learn how to install Windows 11 parallel to Windows 10 without disturbing your existing working environment. So please watch the complete video so you don't miss anything. Before we get started, there are a few requirements. First of all, you need a 8GB external USB drive so you can create a bootable USB drive for Windows 11. Make sure you don't have anything on it because we're going to format it. Next, you need the 64GB of free space on your computer's drive so we can create a separate volume for the Windows 11. Next, you need to download the Windows 11 ISO. If you don't have that, the video's link is in the description. You can watch that video and learn how to download Windows 11 ISO from the Microsoft server. And the last step is you need a bypass secure boot and TPM 2.0 check, a file that we need to bypass this check while installing Windows 11. If your computer supports the secure boot and TPM 2.0, then you don't need that file. So let's see how to dual boot Windows 11 with Windows 10. Simply open up the browser and go to rufus.ie. Scroll down on the page and download the latest version of the Rufus. Once downloaded, go to the downloads folder and run it. Now connect the USB drive. That should be at least 8GB, and you make sure you don't have any data on it because we're going to format it. Once the USB drive is connected, select the USB from the drop-down. Next, select the disk or ISO image in the boot section and then click the select button. Now locate the ISO file of Windows 11. If you don't have ISO file, I have already posted a video and the video's link is in the description. You can see how to download the ISO file from the Microsoft server. Select the ISO file and click open. Next, you need to select the partition scheme. If your BIOS mod is UEFI, then you need to select the GPT. If your BIOS mod is legacy, then you need to select the MBR from the dropdown. If you don't know what is your current BIOS mod, here is how to check it. Simply click the start button and search for the system information. Open the system information, and here on the right side, you can find the BIOS mod, which is legacy on my computer. So I need to select the MBR from the partition scheme. You might have UEFI here, so you need to select the GPT option. So my BIOS mod is legacy, so I need to select the MBR and give it a volume name like Windows 11 and click start. Here you can see it's giving a warning, all data on the device will be destroyed. So make sure you copy all the important data from the USB that you are using for to create that USB bootable USB drive. Click OK to continue. This process will take some time, so sit back and relax. As you can see, the bootable USB drive is almost ready. And the next step we need to do, as my system is not supported with the Windows 11, I don't have the secure boot and the TPM 2.0. It's an old computer, as you can see from the system information. The secure boot is unsupported, and if I check the TPM, there is compatible TPM cannot be found as well. So I need to transfer another file so I can bypass these check while installing the Windows 11. Simply go to the link. Go to that link. You can find that link in the video's description. Go to that link and download the registry file. So once the file is downloaded, I have already downloaded that file. So I'm going to copy it.
copy that file and then go to the bootable USB drive that we just created and paste it on the root folder, and that's it. So the next step is we need to create a separate volume for Windows 11. It's good idea to give it a separate volume instead of installing on an existing one. As you can see, I have installed Windows 10 on my C drive, and on the E volume I have some space, 273 GB free. So I'm gonna divide the E drive into two volumes so I can use one volume for the Windows 11. This way everything will be organized and I do not disturb my existing working environment. So simply right click on the start button and select disk management tool. In the disk management tool, here you can see the E drive, the drive that have a free space of at least 64 GB. Simply right click on it and then select shrink volume. A shrink dialog will be open, and here you need to enter the amount of the space to shrink in MBs. So I am going to create a separate volume of approximately 100 GB, giving it 100,000, so it will be approximately 97 point something GBs. Click shrink button. As you can see, another volume is created which is unallocated. Simply right click on it and select new simple volume. This will start a wizard. It's just very simple. Just click next, next, and it will assign a letter. Just click next. Here you need to give the volume label. Give a proper volume label like Windows 11 volume. This will help us to find the volume while we're installing the Windows 11 later. Click next and then click finish. That's it. The volume is ready for the Windows 11. And as you can see, the new volume is created. So the next thing we need to do is to boot our PC from the bootable USB drive that we created earlier. Connect that bootable USB drive to the computer and then restart your computer. While your computer is rebooting, you need to press a dedicated key for the BIOS setup, which is F10 on my PC. Your BIOS setup key might be different, so you need to consult the documentation or find it from the internet. Find the boot option on your BIOS setup and change the boot order. Make sure the USB drive is the first one in the boot order. So once you reboot your computer, it starts booting from the USB drive. Since the USB drive is on the top, save the settings. I'm going to press F10. It's going to ask me exit saving changing, and I click yes. Here you can see it's asking press any key to boot from the USB drive. So press any key from the keyboard to boot from the USB drive. And here you can see it's just started booting from the USB drive, and in a while we're going to see the setup. Setup is started. Here you need to select language and other preferences and click next. Next you need to click the install now button. Activate Windows. We just don't have the key at the moment, so I don't have the key. Click it. As you can see, I'm getting error, this PC cannot run Windows 11 because I don't have the secure boot and the TPM 2.0, which is the basic requirement for the Windows 11. Remember the file we copied to the bootable USB drive to bypass this check. Here we're gonna use it. Simply press Shift plus F10 shortcut from the keyboard. Type notepad and hit enter. This will open up the notepad window. Simply click the file, select open, select that bootable USB drive. As you can see, you can't see that file, and select all files. Here you can see the BIOS file. Right click on it and simply click merge, then click yes and OK. Now simply close all the windows. This will get back to the same error screen. Simply close that window too. Click yes and again click the install now button. This time click I don't have the product key. This time it will successfully bypass the secure boot and TPM check. As you can see, I don't get this error again, and simply check I accept the Microsoft license terms and click next. So select the custom install. Don't select the upgrade, simply select custom install Windows only. And here you can see the list of all the partition on your computer. Scroll down a little bit and you will find the volume that we created with the name Windows 11 volume. As you can see, it's drive 1 partition 2 Windows 11 volume, which is approximately 97.7 GB. Simply select that volume, carefully select the volume that you created for the Windows 11, otherwise you lose the data. So select that volume and click next. Here you can see the installation is started. So the Windows setup installation will take some time, so be relaxed and wait for it. Once the Windows setup completes the installation, it will restart your computer. And after restarting, on the startup screen you will see the two operating system options. The name for the both operating system is still Windows 10 because it's in development. You can guess the operating system from the volume number. Hit the enter. This will start loading the Windows 11 initial setup. Just follow the on-screen instruction to complete the initial Windows 11 setup. Once you complete the initial Windows setup, you will see the Windows 11 is up and running and you are on the desktop of Windows 11. This is how you can dual boot Windows 11 with Windows 10. If you have any question, please leave a comment below and please do subscribe to my channel.